சங்கர முதல எழுத்தெல்லாம் ஆதி பகவன் முதற்றே.
My search for wonders has taken me to the southern India's end, Kanyakumari. Here stands the tallest statue of the country, the 133 feet statue of Saint Thiruvalluvar, which withstood even the furious tsunami. This statue stands tall, not with the support of Western sciences, but it proclaims our age-old art of sculpting and architecture being practiced by the renowned sculptor Dr. Ganapati Sthapathi.
I belong to the Aboriginal creative tribe of India. During the period of Chakravarti Rajagopalacharya, who was the premier of Madras state, Gandhi Memorial was actually constructed in Madras. My father was the chief designer and builder. His name is Vaidyanatha Sthapathi, and I am actually the son of that great master architect and builder and also sculptor. And I am proud to say that it is an important monument in Madras. I belong to that kind of ancient family, and along that line I have come down to modern times. My grandfather, who was well versed in all languages, even my father, a man of multi languages, they wanted me to go to English school. So I was the first Sthapathi student to go to the English school and study English. So he used to ask me, "Grandson, my dear grandson, please speak in English." Then I used to recite certain poems which I learned in the school. He took enormous pride and joy. In a Hindu temple of Tamil or Dravidian origin, there are two items of unique beauty. They are called Vimanam and also Gopuram. It has got its own significance. So what is the meaning of, literal meaning of Vimanam? Vividham Manam Vimanam. Gopuram is actually the entrance structure. In the same way, you are having the Vimanam at the center over the main sanctum. One gentleman asked me this question. We call our aircraft as Vimanam. Why it is called a Vimanam? Why our structure is also called Vimanam? I said that Vimanam aircraft takes away or brings up our own physical body, whereas this Vimanam takes up high skyward our own inner being or Atma. What is Vastu? Nobody knows. But this is misconstrued nowadays by ordinary people. There is another word before that, Vastu, that is substance, quintessence of the universe, that is called Vastu, which we call in simple English as energy. So Vastu is energy, and the extended form of energy is called Vastu, that is nothing but matter. So energy gives birth to material form. So energy is invisible, whereas Vastu or matter is visible. So matter and energy are one and the same. without vastu, there is no vastu. There is no vastu without energy. In that way, we have been saying for more than 10,000 years. This has been very recently identified like this by Professor Einstein, who said E is equal to MC squared. Every somebody in the olden days used to have a kind of workshop, a small workshop, so that his livelihood can be protected. My workshop is actually a workshop run by my father once upon a time. After my father's demise, I started on a big way. It is going on very well. In fact, I am doing now very huge projects. For instance, for Sri Lanka, I am going to do a kind of a reproduction of Sri Lankan temple and Ranganara image also. So it is going at the cost of 200 crores, are government sponsored. So in this way, it is taking some monstrous dimensions. In future, it will be more also. Whatever I have earned, I am using it for creating a kind of monumental structure in memory of the great man, Mayan, who actually gave this Indian culture, Tamil culture, in this land called Bharat. Pieces, creative pieces. One piece is the image of Madhavi, the heroine of Salapadigaram. Next one is, we have heard of the beauty of Tamil by our ear. If you are interested in seeing visually that the beauty of Tamil language, you must go and see the sculpture of Tamil Thai, which I produced and installed in Madurai, as well as in Karaikudi. I also hold it as very supreme. It is actually Salapadigaram rendered in visual form, in sculptural form. And Dr. Kalinger has done one museum or art gallery, where we have narrated the story of Kannagi. And what I have produced, they are all called narrative sculptures. It is only during this period, and Dr. Kalinger's period, this kind of narrative sculptures were produced. Before that, there were there, these narrative sculptures. But during the middle period, everything disappeared, because patrons never liked this kind of thing. Because they had to spend quite a lot of money, therefore it was stopped. And I was very happy to do all these things. That is also successful. Initially, there was a temple of Subramanya, and it was also in dilapidated condition. And the central image, Subramanya with Valli and Devasena, were there. But no Abhishekam, no Puja, nothing of that sort was performed. The present Swami, by name Balamurugan Adimai, he wanted to do some kind of worship. Therefore, he went up, saw the image of Subramanya himself in luminous form. Then thereafter, he became what is called an ascetic or sage. So from that time onwards, he wanted to remove the old structure and build a new structure all in stone. And today, if you go there, you will be struck with wonder how this one single soul was able to produce a very magnificent edifice. He went very recently and visited all temples, including Madurai temple. And he made exclamatory remarks about Madurai temple, that the big pillar, nobody can lift, nobody can put erect, all these things, wonderful things I have seen. But I am not able to see my own temple anywhere in Tamil Nadu. But so great my temple is. That is an encomium made by him to my actual concept and also my work. The great Valluvar Kottam, which I did in Madras, which everybody has seen, nobody can repeat, my dear sir, because into that I have thrust or put the mathematics. also is a very standing monument, never to be produced by anybody, and even before me nobody produced, because actually when we do temple car, we create a cubical structure, put wheels on both sides, then say it is a temple, that is a ratham or tear. But actually the tear will be very narrow at the bottom and going like this, widening, that inverted pyramid. That inverted pyramid in stone is very difficult to make, which I was able to do successfully and boldly for our government of Tamil Nadu. And I can't forget the great man, Dr. Karunanidhi, who induced me and encouraged me to do this boldly. I did this successfully. Nobody has appreciated, my dear sir. I don't know. The most important monument in the whole world. I have seen almost all big monuments in pictures and also by direct contact. The Brigadeswara Temple Monument is the best of all the monuments in the whole world, my dear sir. President of India, Abdul Kalam, came to Madras to open a small section of our Madras Museum. He asked some of the people who were assembled there, can anybody say why this monument is still standing all right without collapsing, though it is going tapering, pyramidal? What is the mathematics behind it? He asked. Nobody was able to reply. Highly learned people were there around him, but they were not able to understand, because I said, I have been saying all along, that there is what is called a technical treatise governing all these items of visual objects. And that technical thing is available only in Tamil as well as in Sanskrit. So technical Sanskrit, technical Tamil are separately existing, my dear sir. Nobody has touched the that science. So nowhere in any of our colleges it has been mentioned, it has been taken up as a subject of research or subject of or teaching. In the Brigadeswara temple, though it is going pyramidal up to the finial, it is hollow from the bottom to the top. When you stand at the center of your sanctum, if you look at upward, then you will see the topmost small hole which is visible at the top. So it is hollow, no intermediate slabs or beams. Brigadeswara temple has come under the list of UNESCO for preservation. This statue was carved out of hard granite, taken from three important quarries. We have procured important and best stones from different places. And we actually produce a kind of model also for this statue. It consists of some 700 pieces. All pieces were actually done in actual sizes and reproduced in stone. The palm length is 10 feet and face length is 10 feet. And the Tirukkural manuscript held in the hand, in the left hand, that is also 10 feet. So everything is 10, 10, 10, 10. That is actually the module or modular measure or space-time unit I have used in the making of the statue of Tiruvalluvar. So I call it divine, because that is a divine measure which we have used in the making of smaller sized god forms. I have made Tiruvalluvar as God. He is actually God of Tamil people. Do you think I am still youthful? Yes, there is one secret. Actually, I have experienced what is called the spiritual experience. In all the sculptures and monuments I produced, I was able to see my own inner feeling taking a visual form. This is one of the reasons why I am looking young today, as put by you. The last one I did is actually known to everybody. The great statue of Tiruvalluvar. Everybody is asking me a question, what next? My answer is, I have to make the great image or statue of Thandai Cheriyar. Because according to my own impression, he is the only gentleman who was able to change the color of the society. The downtrodden people have come up like anything, and they have changed their own colors also. They are all now well placed, well educated, all on account of the great propaganda that he made.
Dr. Ganapati Sthapathi, served as the principal of College of Traditional Architecture and Sculpture at Chennai for over 2 decades. A man deeply rooted in the ancient culture of India, he endeavors to keep this age-old art alive through various means. He runs his own International Institute of Nayonic Science and Technology and trains architects and engineers in Vastu Shastra based building architecture.
Dr. Ganapati Staffati, he is one of the most amazing beings I have ever met. And I was lucky enough to go to Kauai for the middle Vastu ceremony there of the temple. And I met this very humble, wise man who embodies Vastu. And in a very short period of time, it confirmed what I felt in my heart, that I had to come here to India to study with him.
I am associated with Dr. Ganapati Staffati for the past 12 years. I have visited many of his temples. I used to enjoy the aesthetic beauty of the sculptures, architecture beauty of the temple. Apart from all this, I worship his dedication to his work.
Our Vastashastra describes the qualities of Staffati. Staffati is Sarvashastrajnaha. Staffati should be expert in all fields. He should be a musician, he should be a grammarian, he is a poet. So I think the verse is suitable to Dr. Ganapati Staffati.
I am an architect from Modern School of Architecture. I was very much fascinated with the works of Dr. Ganapati Staffati. And when I came in association with him, I learned a great many things about the traditional architectural system. The most important principle that I learned from him is that a building is a living organism, and this quality can be achieved only by following three qualities, that is Ramyam, Bhogam and Sukadarsham. Ramyam is a peace, spiritual peace, Bhogam is the materialistic qualities, and Sukadarsham is the aesthetic principles.
He has written several books on this subject and has won many a recognition. Though Dr. Ganapati Staffati has built more than 1,000 temples around the world, and despite his ripe old age of 82, he refuses to retire. He travels widely to design and erect temples. Apart from temples, he has architected many buildings too. His fusion of temple and building architecture can be vividly seen in this Tamil University building of Tanjavur. Even now, he designs without a tremor or shake. Sculpts attractive images. He is planning to build a mammoth Jain temple in Delhi.
The wisdom that Dr. Staffati has in Vastu, both of his sharing of it with the world and his execution of it, is profound. And I feel he is not only a treasure of India, he's a treasure of the world.
அன்புடையாம் எங்கும் உரிய பிறர்க்கு